Hi, I'm Paul Duty with Glime Aviation. In this video, I'm going to give you some tips for using the touchscreen instrument panel on the Glime Virtual Cockpit BATD. Most buttons require a simple touch to send a command to the simulator. Nearly every button and switch on screen is functional, but there are a few that are purely cosmetic. To use a switch, a simple flick or slide with your fingertip works best. Don't try to grab a switch with two fingers. Levers and wheels, such as the fuel selector, flaps, and trim, require a simple sliding motion, as you can see here. The fuel shutoff lever on this panel would normally be pulled out to activate. A simple downward flick of the finger will pull the lever, shutting off the fuel. An upward flick will push the lever back in. Knobs take a little more practice to get used to their operation. When you place your finger on the edge of a knob, you'll see two yellow arrows showing that the knob can be turned. Slide your finger around the edge of the knob to turn it incrementally, simulating the twisting action of a physical knob. Some knobs have multiple functions. For example, the range and pan knob on the G1000. This knob can be twisted or deflected to simulate different functions. However, the knob itself is simulated in 2D. Here's how to use each function. For twisting, you'll slide your finger around the knob just like any other single-purpose knob. To use the pan function, tap once on the knob and you'll see four yellow circles appear around the knob. Each of these circles can be touched to simulate deflections to control the pan functions. Tap the knob again to switch back to the twist functions. One function that takes the most practice is using concentric stacked knobs, such as those found on the Garmin 530, where there is an inner and outer knob. Much like any training maneuver, this takes some practice to build proficiency. The inner and outer areas for each knob are closely aligned, but they have distinctly different functions. Practice with these knobs and you'll develop the technique in no time. When using any touchscreen, make sure your hands are clean, especially your fingertips. I recommend using hand sanitizer containing alcohol. If you use a natural hand sanitizer, make sure it does not have any fragrances made from essential oils and avoid lotions, especially those that leave you feeling oily or greasy. Keeping your fingertips dry will help ensure that they slide easier around the knobs on the screen. Finally, clean your screen. The touchscreen has an anti-glare coating, which is naturally smudge resistant. However, oils, dirt, and grime from your fingers can still affect your ability to smoothly use these screen functions. To clean your screen, turn it off. Then, use a screen cleaning wipe or a soft, dry, lint-free cloth. Microfiber cloths work best. When necessary, you can slightly dampen the cloth with water, isopropyl alcohol containing 70% alcohol or less, or an eyeglass cleaner. If you use any liquid, always dampen your cloth. Never spray any liquid directly onto the screen and never use glass cleaner or other chemical cleaners. I recommend using straight wipes across the screen rather than circular motions. After you wipe dirt and grime away, use a different cloth and wipe off any remaining dust. Take the time to learn these techniques and you'll soon be proficient with the touchscreen panel. Then, you can save the grease for your landings. Keep your hands clean and have fun with your Glime Virtual Cockpit BATD.